differently, abled differently. Chelagat used to fall a lot until she was diagnosed with a condition that affects the retina. Take a look.
One thing that I knew that it wasn't a normal thing is that, quote-unquote, normal. Yeah, it's because I experienced night blindness. Seeing at night wasn't possible. At the same time, waddling into a pool of water on the road. Because, you know, during the day, people just know that I'll just evade the water pools. But for sure, I just waddle like nothing. There's nothing. Yeah, so my dad was just looking at me, just like, okay, Chela, what's happening? You remember he took me to hospital, and doctor, till one day out of boredom, on Tuesday, 2015, 19th of October, with my younger sister, we decided, since we don't have anything to do, sit on at hospital, PCA, we were looking for trouble. That's when I was diagnosed with retinitis pigmentosa. And the best thing that I love about the breaking of news is that the doctor didn't tell me. I was sent to a low vision psychologist. That's something that I truly, truly appreciate till date. Because even some days ago, I was talking to my therapist, low vision, Agnes, and she was telling me, like, she's so happy the way I'm going on with my life. And I believe in some way it's how the news was broken to me. Because, of course, the doctor would have just said, okay, you're going to be blind, your retinitis pigmentosa, we can't help you, you go home. But at least with Agnes, she took me through, she wanted to know what I'm doing, and if at all there's a change in life, and boom, she tells you. But anyway, that's what I love. The health communication is something that I think people should really enhance and just find a way of breaking tough diagnosis to people.
Diagnosed with retinitis pigmentosa, a rare incurable condition that affects the retina, acceptance has had quite a positive impact on her life.
I remember in 2015 when I was diagnosed with retinitis pigmentosa, that is a genetic eye disorder, that is robbing away my sight. I thought, my life is already done, so what am I supposed to do again? Career, how will I be able to continue to socially interact with people? How will I be economically empowered? Just so many questions, and I was just like, okay, it's a tough journey to be in. I guess I have a very good attitude. That's something that I always, I'm so proud of. And a very good support system, especially my family, my friends who feels like they own me now, and my church. They've been very, very, very supportive. Yeah.
She believes that motivation, which is the driving force behind human as actions, is self-driven.
I highly believe that motivation only comes from within. If it doesn't come from within, you won't be able. As much as family can push you to achieve what you really want to achieve, it won't be possible.
As Chela pursues her career and education, she's also a lover of photography and cooking.
I really love writing. I think it's just in me. Speaking. I always say that my talent is in speaking, talking. And also, photography, of course, I squint a lot, but I try as much as possible to do that. Cooking and just pursuing my career, because even currently I'm finishing my master's, so I'm just researching on my thesis, and it's something that I really love. I would really want to push myself even to do even my PhD, and just let other people know, regardless of your shortcomings, you can still do whatever you want to do. No limitations at all.
Coming to terms of completely losing her sight one day is just part of the challenges she has encountered.
Mine is just not knowing where you're supposed to belong, especially with low vision. You know, my sight goes gradually because my situation is just incurable. So ultimately I lose my sight completely, but not scared of it. I think I've already coped with that. It's much more people not understanding that blindness is a spectrum. Yeah. They should not see a person with closed eyes or with a defect on their eyes, and they could see, like, okay, this person is really blind. I used to have extreme insomnia. I think I had so much fear of unknown. I'd never experienced, like, even interacting with any person with vision impairments. I didn't know what it is and how life would be. I had so much fear, and it was just like, oh, okay, how will I be able to accomplish my life goals? I think that was the main fear that I had, because, you know, with vision impairment, there's a lot of struggles that you go through for you to accomplish what you really wanted to accomplish.
Clearly, one wouldn't be able to tell off Chela's condition just by the looks. There is therefore need for awareness creation at all levels regarding the various medical conditions in existence.
If you look at me, you won't even know even the kind of energy that I have. You won't even know that I'm not even able to see. Yeah. It's important to educate the public, because I realized even people now are still struggling to either tell if my white cane is that stick for using for camera, or is this something you're working with it, because my own is just white purely, and they don't know much about it. Just like, okay, what are you using these? Why are you carrying these? And what is it for? And at least now I've done my best. They know what's the use of a white cane, and whenever they see a person with a white cane, what does it mean to them, and which kind of help they're supposed to give to that person. At the same time, what you say about awareness and advocacy, I always tend to believe whichever the space that you are in, you have that responsibility to do. Not just talking, even your own actions, even your own, when it comes to academics, you have to not even prove, because I don't believe in proving things. Do your best for people even to see, like, indeed, disability is intelligent, disability is beautiful, disability is just an amazing thing, not everything negative, just like disability, you know, when somebody hears disability, everything negative.
Yeah. Retinitis pigmentosa is a rare condition that damages the retina.
It's very rare. It affects 1 in 4,000. It's incurable, meaning that you lose your sight gradually with time. But it depends with individuals. Some other people will, maybe 2 years, 3 years down the line, they don't have sights. But others, they can still go on with their sight, limited sight, for some time. With it's a few minute management, because it comes with secondary diseases like macular edema, cataract, early cataracts, and so forth. What else? Symptoms, night blindness, tunnel vision, where you're not able to see sides. Like, for instance, if I'm looking at you, I'll only be able to look at your eyes only. I won't be able to accommodate your face, the entire face. If I want to look at your legs, I will just move towards your leg. That's why I chose to use my white cane. Yeah.
This condition has no cure, but low vision aids and rehabilitation programs can help a lot. To celebrate the achievements of people who are blind and mark the importance of white cane as a tool of independence, 15th October has been set aside as the National White Cane Safety Day that is celebrated annually and globally. For Chela, she uses a white cane and a smart band as assistive mobility device.
I use a white cane. Of course, I struggle with it. I don't know, I had my own things in my head, but now I'm just, I love rocking my white cane. I would say persons with disabilities should just come out and speak out. That's it, because I can't speak out. I can't speak for other people with physical challenge. That's why I always say I'm not a disability advocate. I'm a blind advocate. I won't advocate for a different disability, because I'm not experiencing it. I don't know the kind of challenges people go through. I won't be able to come with the solutions. Yeah, I think people should just, whichever the disability that you have, speak about it, like, plainly, because we love sugarcoating things and not coming to terms with the reality. Like, for instance, the kind of terms we use whenever a person says, "Chela, you're blind." "I have no problem." What's the reality? Call a spade a spade. Yeah, because anyway, what is blindness? It's not being able to see well or totally not being able to see. That's it. Call a spade a spade. Oh, Chela would want, she's looking forward to be a great positive influencer, especially to women with vision impairment, because realize there's a gap, a real gap, and they really want them to realize that they should just come out of their cocoons, just stay away from the comfort zone, stay away from, of course, the family comes in with, I always tend to feel sometimes the family can suffocate you, not really support you, but rise over it and just try new things, because blindness, there's a lot of isolation and loneliness. But you have to fight it yourself and just be an extraordinary person and a person of great influence.
Nothing should be a hindrance to attaining our goals and dreams.
There's no excuse. Even the way you present yourself, the way you dress yourself, there's no excuse just because of you have a disability or not. No. You know, interestingly, it was just yesterday I was telling my friend who lost her sight, I think 2 years ago, discrimination doesn't come from other people. It starts from you. You start discriminating yourself. Oh, I should not go there because other people see me like this. Oh, see you, nini, nini, and all that kind of pitiness. Let's tend to say and believe discrimination doesn't really exist until you allow, you leave that void for the people now to come in with the discrimination. Because for me, you can't discriminate me. you can't. And I won't allow that. Because even when I go for social activities, because I don't want to limit myself. I don't want. And even being part of the leadership of young professionals, they don't see me like Chela with a white cane or something of the sort, or Chela with blindness or something. They always like seeing Chela who brings with a lot of vibe, positive vibes, good energy, and when it comes to planning, I would really want to come with something that with a lot of quality and just out of the world. I've gone to very many different places, but I tend to, where human beings to me is just a good place. Because if we can converse with you just the way like this, without having that term of disability or anything, I will be able to learn so much about you. I would be able to learn so much about life and how best can I be of great help to you. And you will also learn from me how best can I be of great help to you. Because human beings, you know, we can never work with oneself. It's a teamwork. Life is all about teamwork. Even success is just all about teamwork.
Let's catch a breather, but we'll be right back shortly.
Differently abled, differently.